Hello everyone, welcome to Jades of Tech. I'm Vikram P. Maduri here. In this session, let's discuss about SAP RFC. This concept is one of the most important concept every SAP consultant or prospective SAP consultants must know. Anybody who is associated with SAP field must be knowing what exactly is RFC and what is basic functionality and advantages of RFC. Now, the first and foremost in the what is SAP RFC, let's understand the full form of RFC. RFC stands for Remote Function Call. RFC is basically used to send and receive data from one SAP system to another SAP system. As we see in the diagram, we have one SAP R3 system getting interaction with SAP BW system, and SAP BW interacting with SAP CRM, and then SAP SCM. So these interactions are taking place within SAP environment. Now for this, we use RFC. RFC is a mechanism that allows business applications to communicate and exchange information in a predefined formats with other systems, predominantly between SAP to SAP systems. So RFC consists of two interfaces, a calling interface for ABAP programs, a calling interface for non-SAP programs. So most of the times RFC, we use it for SAP to SAP systems, but it can also be used with non-SAP systems as well. So any ABAP program can call a remote function call with call function and destination statement. The destination parameter tells the SAP system that the called function runs in a system other than the callers. Now the logical destinations are defined via transaction SM59 and stored in RFC DES. So here we have, let's take an example of system Y and system Z. So between the system Y and system Z, there is a protocol through which the data has been transferred from this system to that system. This is where we use the RFC. Now in SAP, RFC interface system is used for setting up RFC connections between the different systems and also between SAP and non-SAP systems as well. And what's most important to know about RFC is it uses CPIC, Common Programming Interface for Communication protocol, to transfer data between systems. It is SAP specific protocol, and remote function call is a communication interface based on CPIC, but with more functions and easier for application programmers to use. The RFC library functions support the C programming language and Visual Basic on Windows platform. RFC connections can always be used across the entire system. This means that an RFC connection you have defined in client 000 can be used from client 100 without any difference. RFC is the protocol for calling special subroutines. That's called, those are the function modules over the network. Function modules are comparable with the C functions or Pascal procedures. They have a defined interface through which data, tables, and written codes can be exchanged. Function modules are managed in the R3 system in their own function library called the function builder. Now the function builder, the transaction code is C37. Provides application programmers with a useful environment for programming, documenting, and testing function modules that can be called locally as well as remotely. The R3 system automatically generates the additional code, the RFC stub, needed for remote calls. You maintain the parameters of RFC connection using the transaction code SM59. The R3 system is also delivered with an RFC SDK, that's Software Development Kit, that uses extensive C libraries to allow external programs to be connected to the R3 system. The only difference between a remote call of a function module to another server and a local call is a special parameter destination. I'm going to use this in a live scenario. I'll be creating a remote enabled function module and I'll be calling it from another system, which I'll be explaining in a scenario in another session that specifies the target server on which the program is to be executed. Now, the RFC advantages. RFC helps to reduce the efforts of programmers by letting them avoid the redevelopment of modules and methods at remote systems. It is capable enough of to convert the data into format understandable by the remote target system. Call up certain routines which are necessary to start communication with the remote system. Handle errors that might occur in the process of communication. Now, there are types of RFCs: synchronous RFC, asynchronous RFC, transactional RFC, and queued RFC. Now, synchronous RFC is the oldest one, which requires both the systems, client and server, to be available at the time of communication of data transfer. It is the most common type and is required when the result is required immediately after the execution of a synchronous RFC. Now, the best example that we can relate to synchronous RFC is a phone call. When you make a call to some other person, that person's phone should be switched on. And if you call them now, the system should be on. Their mobile phone should be on now. But if it's switched off, you will not be able to connect to that system. So that's similar to synchronous RFC. Now, when we talk about asynchronous RFC, has, even if the server to which we are trying to reach is switched off or it's not available or it's not reachable, this asynchronous RFC still keeps trying to reach the server, and until it reaches the server, it keeps trying to reach the server. So let's say if you are trying to reach system B from system A, it keeps trying to hit the system B. When it is not able to hit it, then after a couple of hours or minutes, whatever it might be, it will create a log. This is similar to our SMS. So when you send an SMS to some person, that SMS first tries to go and hit the mobile, but if the mobile is switched off, as soon as the mobile is switched on, then that SMS that you have sent them, the message that you have sent them, reaches to their phone. So it's asynchronous RFC is similar to that. And transactional RFC is kind of an asynchronous RFC. And it is similar to what we do in the asynchronous RFC. And it will be basically sent multiple times due to some network issues. So for example, the remote system need not be available at the time when the RFC's client program is executing in transactional RFC. The transactional RFC component stores the called remote function call together with the corresponding data in the SAP database under a unique transaction ID. And then it's created as a log. Now the TRFC is similar to asynchronous RFC as it does not wait for the target system. So if the system is not available, it will write the data into a asynchronous RFC table with a transaction SM50 ID. So that you can see in SM50, which is picked up with the scheduler RSAR FCSE extension of asynchronous RFC. Now, queued RFC is an extension of transaction RFC. It also ensures that individual steps are processed in sequence to guarantee that multiple logical unit of works are processed in the order specified by the application. Transactional RFC can be serialized using queues, inbound and outbound queues, hence the name queued RFC, used for extension of transactional RFC for a defined processing sequence. Implementation of QRFC is recommended if you want to guarantee that several transactions are processed in a predefined order. Now, types of RFC connections. We have different types of RFC connections. ABAP connection, it's represented by 3. HTTP connection to external server, G. Internal connections, I. SNA CPI connections, S. TCP IP connections, T. And connections via ABAP driver, X. Now, type 3 entries specify the connection between ABAP systems. Here we must specify the host name and the IP address. You can, however, specify logon information if desired. This is applicable for both type of RFCs between ABAP systems and external calls to ABAP systems. And type I entries specify ABAP systems connect to the SAP database as the current system. These entries are predefined and cannot be modified. Example, entry name WS0015K1824. So WS0015, it's a host name, and K18 is the system name, 24 is a TCP service name. So type T destinations are connections to external programs that use the RFC APIs to receive RFCs. The activation type can be either start or registration. If it is start, you must specify the host name and the path name of the program to be started. How to create an RFC? In the function module attributes trap transaction, set the processing type as remote enable module to create a remote function module. So these were the few details about RFC. I'll be coming up with more such related topics related to RFC and how can we create an RFC connection between the two systems, in between SAP to SAP systems, and how do we call the call function. And so I'll take an example and explain you in the later coming sessions. So if at all, if you haven't yet subscribed, please do subscribe to our channel, youtube.com/JSRTech, so that you can get alerts about all the latest news that we are discussing. And you can contact us at training@jsrtech.com if you are looking out for any kind of trainings. And if you're looking out for jobs, you can contact us at jobs@jsrtech.com. That's our email ID. Thank you. Have a great day.